So we were discussing about the certain experiments on digestion. And first experiment, let us discuss about the action of saliva on starch. Saliva, I have taught, it is released by our salivary gland. And what is the action of saliva on starch? We have discussed that saliva contains salivary amylase or tylene, and it converts, changes the starch into a type of sugar, that is maltose sugar, and maltose by the help of enzyme maltase is changed to glucose. The theory part we have discussed. Here, the practical part of that we are going to discuss. Now make a suspension. In chemistry, you must have read about different type of solution. True solution, aqueous solution, colloidal solution, suspension. So here we have to prepare a suspension. How do you prepare a suspension? Take 1 gram of starch plus 100 ml of water. Where to get starch? While you throw the water from the boiled rice, that is starch, or you can buy revive, that is also starch. Stored food in the plant is the starch, and stored food in animal is glycogen. Glucose is prepared by photosynthesis and stored in the form of starch. So take 1 gram of starch and 100 ml of water, heat in a beaker. Now after heating, this is your beaker and you have heated it. After heating, take 3 test tubes. Name the test tube as A, B and C. And put this suspension in 3 of the test tubes. In last test tube, a little bit is required, not more. And in A, this test tube A, do a starch test. Dear children, we will discuss in detail about the starch test by iodine solution. You will get result that this starch is present. Starch is present because this, when you put iodine solution, the starch, the solution, the suspension will turn into blue black. Very clear? It will turn blue black. Now, second, check sugar, because that starch by the help of salivary amylase or saliva is changed into sugar maltose. We have taken starch and plus 100 ml of water and send it for sugar test in laboratory. Sugar test, as it is done in the case of diabetes after taking blood. What you will find? Positive result. Means sugar is present. It means this starch is turned into sugar. Third, suspension. Third, a little bit suspension you have taken in the test tube and added saliva from your mouth. How more amount of saliva is increased in our mouth? While we do practical, we give rubber band or wax to the children to chew it. If you will put rubber band or wax in your mouth and chew, more amount of saliva is formed in our mouth, and that saliva is poured in the test tube. And this test tube contains suspension. Now you have poured saliva in this test tube. Hold it for 15 minutes in your hand. Our body temperature is about 37.6 degrees or 38 degrees. Hold it for 15 minutes. What you will see? You will see that this starch is changed into sugar. And here also, in C also, positive sugar result. Means sugar is formed in this B and C. You haven't put sugar, but the starch which was present, which was changed into sugar. Here it changed, and here by the help of saliva it changed to. Clearly understood or not? We will discuss how sugar test is done in laboratory. In the next part we will discuss. Now this action of saliva on starch is clear. We can prove it in laboratory that by the help of saliva starch is changed into a sugar. Very clear. And now next experiment let us discuss. And that experiment is action of pepsin on the protein. We have discussed that our stomach contains gastric gland. Gastric gland releases gastric juice. Gastric juice contains hydrochloric acid, mucus, and pepsin. And pepsin helps to digest protein. And first, pepsinogen, then pepsin, and then protein is digested to peptide and amino acid. Let us see it practically. From where we will get protein? Where we will get that? Because pepsin breaks protein into peptides and amino acids. How we can get protein? Protein is present in milk, paneer, and different food items. Let us take egg. Our second experiment is experiment to prove or action of pepsin on white egg. Action of pepsin on egg white. Now let me discuss. You have must have eaten egg. I am not talking to boil egg and eat. I am talking about the raw egg. Just break it. If you will break the egg, some fluid part is present inside the egg, and in fluid part the white and yellow, two things are there. Yellow color part of the egg is called as yolk, and white colored part of the egg is called albumin. Try to understand. If you will break the egg, white and yellow both part will come. Don't make it omelet. Here we are going to do experiment. Leave it. This part you can eat, can make cook omelet, but here we need white part, and white part is the albumin. Very clear. Take white part of the egg, and that is albumin. This white part take in a beaker. White part of egg and put white part of the egg in a beaker, and your beaker will contain 500 ml of water plus 500 ml water. Understood? And after putting 500 ml of water, stir it again. This white part mixed in water, in 500 ml half liter water, and stir it. Don't drain, neither do anything. Okay, then what you will do? Boil water and white part of the egg. Boil it. What will happen? It will turn into a cloudy solution. It will turn cloudy, means not clear. Cloudy, and that cloudy solution is called a suspension. That cloudy solution is called a suspension. Now, take four test tubes. Take four test tubes. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Take four test tubes. Make it A, B, this is C, and this is D. Take four test tubes. Okay. And put this suspension in all the four. Okay. Whatever you have wired, that part from the beaker, put it inside the test tube. A little bit. Okay, say 3 mm. In each, put 3 mL of suspension in the four test tube named as A, B, C, and D. Now, let us do something. Add 1% solution. 1% solution of what? Pepsin plus hydrochloric acid. Add 1% solution of pepsin and hydrochloric. Take in A. Where is A? Here. What you will do? Add only pepsin. Suspension. Plus, what I have told, in A suspension means this part you have taken 3 mL, 3 mL you have taken, and add pepsin. Leave it for some time. In A, added pepsin. In B, second thing, only hydrochloric acid plus HCl. In A, added pepsin. In B, added hydrochloric acid. In C and D, what you will add? Let us see. In C, add pepsin plus hydrochloric acid. Here, add pepsin plus hydrochloric acid. Now, in D, what you will add? Only hydrochloric acid you have added. Pepsin plus hydrochloric acid. Pepsin in D, acid. This hydrochloric acid and boiled pepsin. Here, acid plus boiled pepsin. Now, see the result. In four of the test tube, you have put the suspension, 3 mL of suspension. In A, you added pepsin. In B, added hydrochloric acid. In C, added pepsin plus hydrochloric acid. And in D, added HCl plus boiled pepsin. Pepsin separately you have boiled. And mixed it, hydrochloric acid, and added. Now, what I have taught, that pepsin digest the protein. Pepsin digest the protein. Where we have added pepsin? Here. It will be not digested. Protein will be not digested. What you will see? In C, this cloudy suspension will change into clear solution. C change to clear solution. Only C will change to clear solution. Very clear or not? Once more try to understand. Take a fourth test tube and in A put pepsin, in B hydrochloric acid, C C, pepsin plus hydrochloric acid. D, pepsin plus boiled pepsin plus hydrochloric acid. Now, you can boil all the four. First, do one thing. In a large beaker, this A, B, C, D, after keep it boiling, and then only see the result. What result you are getting? What you will get? That C will change to clear solution. C here it will change to clear solution. Why it will change to clear solution? Protein is there, means white part of the egg is there, which is albumin, a type of protein. Pepsin you have added, plus hydrochloric acid you have added. It will be digested. Protein will be digested. It will change into clear solution. What does it shows? That pepsin in the presence of hydrochloric acid, that part is important. If the medium is acidic, then only pepsin will work and pepsin will digest the protein. That I want to say, that pepsin works only in the acidic medium and will digest the protein. Here the solution will remain cloudy because only pepsin is there but no hydrochloric acid. Our stomach produces hydrochloric acid also and makes the food acidic. Here only hydrochloric acid is there but pepsin is not there, so there will be no digestion of the protein albumin. Indeed, hydrochloric acid is there, pepsin is also there, but pepsin is boiled, and pepsin after boiling it will not work only under optimum temperature, and in boiling optimum temperature is crossed, so it is destroyed, it will not digest protein. But here pepsin is there and hydrochloric acid is there. The protein albumin, white part of the egg, will be digested and the solution will become clear. And this proves that pepsin digests the protein. Next test, let us discuss what is that effect of acidity and alkalinity on enzyme reaction. Let us discuss effect of acidity and alkalinity on enzyme reaction. Dear children, these things are very important. If possible, I will try to show in the laboratory, but here only theory part is I am discussing. See here, second thing which we have to discuss, that is effect of acidity and alkalinity. Effect of acidity and alkalinity. Effect of acidity and alkalinity. Effect of acidity and alkalinity on enzyme reaction. On an enzyme reaction. Means enzyme, you are knowing biocatalyst. What is the effect of acidity and alkalinity? Acidity you are knowing, alkalinity also you are knowing. Listen. Egg white, take one more test tube, and in this test tube, that egg white one means suspension, egg white, that was albumin, and albumin is a protein, egg white one, and name it ABCD, we have finished, name it this test tube as E, and from that beaker, don't use all the whatever you have boiled, egg white plus 500 ml of water.
water you have boiled, don't use it for test tube. Keep it for fifth test tube also. And the fifth test tube is E. Put some amount of suspension in test tube E. Okay, we are going to see acidity and alkalinity on an enzyme reaction. Very clear. Now, add here pepsin. Pepsin digests the protein. Add a little bit pepsin. And then we have to add acid and base. Here, let us add sodium bicarbonate. It is a base. Sodium bicarbonate formula knowing NaHCO3 or sodium hydrogen carbonate. Sodium bicarbonate, it is a base, and bases which are soluble in water are known as alkali. So AY you have taken and added pepsin plus sodium bicarbonate. Now heat it up to 35 degrees Celsius. Don't cross the limit 35 degrees because the enzyme will not work. So heat up to 35 degrees Celsius. And see the result. What will be the result? No change. What does it prove? That pepsin or an enzyme do not work in alkali medium. If the medium is alkali, it will not work. Very clear. Now, this part is clear. And if acidic is the medium, acid is there, say HCl, hydrochloric acid, what will happen? If you will add pepsin, the solution will become clear. It means it digests the protein, except their protein. Now, starting, this was about the test of this action of or effect of acidity and alkalinity on an enzyme.